Hello, everybody. welcome to this end of year energy reading live stream to kind of complete this year and align with our intentions for next year. And my ring light isn't working, but there are these lovely rays coming in, and I know you can see all these little dust motes going past. So yes, and I thought I would be in the Christmas spirit. So welcome. This is a really just tuning into and co-creating with anybody who's here live, and also anybody who is wanting to join in the replay. If you're joining in the replay, just really feel into it as if it's happening in that moment that you're joining. And really have that sense of, allowing yourself to come into the place where you're fully in this moment. You're allowing all the different pieces that have been going on through the year to come to whatever completion is right for this time. So that then you can kind of clear your space to have a sense of what it is you'd love to be experiencing or bringing in next year. So hi everybody, welcome. I see a few people hopping on. If you want to say hello, do. So if you want to just really take a moment to just come into this moment right now. So if you want to just feel your weight on the chair and your feet on the ground. Hey Rosaline, welcome. And bring your attention to, it's like let go of anything you might be thinking of or you might be have going on, because obviously it's a busy time of the year. So just imagine you're kind of parking it and just leaving it for the moment. And breathe. And just let yourself land in this moment. Hey Daphne, welcome. Oh, good to have you join live too. Hello. So anybody who's joining live, feel free to, engage, because this is co-created. So, it's very much relevant to whatever it is that's going on for you. So, and again, anyone joining in the replay, it's still very relevant for you. And if you want to imagine or just think back over the last year and all the different things that have been going on in the last year, the multitude of different things going on, and if you want to really acknowledge, how you coped with it all, how you were through it all, really acknowledge, how, you've got to this point, you've navigated the way through. And so just take a moment to really, appreciate yourself and to value yourself and feel a sense of, appreciation for yourself. And just notice and see how does that feel. And breathe. And if you want to notice any areas that stood out to you, so this could be, anything you were experiencing that stood out to you, this could be something that was difficult, or it could be something that you feel went really well, or that you feel really good about. So just notice anything that catches your attention. Okay. And anything that feels good, just imagine you're really receiving, just like feel that, have that sense of yes around it. And again, like a sense of maybe celebration or a sense of gratitude or appreciation for it and for yourself and everything that you received within that. And yeah, so you're really, I suppose you're really embodying the good things about it. So maybe there is a sense of accomplishment or a sense of peace or a sense of achievement or a sense of love or a different thing. So just imagine and allow yourself to really embody those feelings. Hey, thanks for hearts. it feels like a big piece about embodying what it is that that feels really good. Because of course, when we embody something, we can experience more of it. Okay, and just keep breathing. And anything that feels unfinished or incomplete or feels like I don't feel so good about this, or anything that feels like there's still some strands or some energies that are not complete, if you want to put your attention on those. and have the intention that you want to complete them whatever way is right for you. So anything that you're ready to let go of and release from your system, from your energy, then just have the intention you're allowing that to release. And anything that you feel you want support with, still, just have the intention that you're allowing support to come in for that. And notice how you're feeling in your body. So feel, you know, how are you feeling around your hips and your legs? To me, there's a feeling of kind of holding. It's like we've been holding ourselves. It's like, okay, I just need to kind of keep getting through this and just, ooh. And sometimes when we're just holding ourselves like this, you know, our energy doesn't flow as freely. So if you have a sense of holding, then notice it and breathe and imagine that you're just letting go. How's anybody feeling so far? Can you feel things going on? Or do you have a sense of, you know, of the different things that we're speaking about? Can you relate to the pieces that are coming in so far? So if you do, just let me know. Okay. And there is, so I'm getting a sense of a door opening. So if you imagine a door opening. And as this door is opening, there's a sense of receiving. So imagine that whatever this door means to you, that you're allowing yourself to receive. And this feels like it continues a little bit from last week when we were talking about the giving and the receiving in balance and in harmony. So this is around like continuing to allow ourselves to receive even more. Okay. And notice how you feel about receiving with this open door. So to me, it feels a little bit like, oh, you know, is it okay? Is it okay that I receive? So notice how you feel. You may feel something completely different. You might go yes, or you might just go no. So just notice how you're feeling right now. And again, breathe. So there's an energy coming in, which is, again, it's got that unlocking feeling. It's kind of coming in like this here, kind of waving or wafting down through our channel. A lot going on around the tummy area. So if you want to notice your tummy area. And the low back and your hips. And down through your legs. Allow the energy to come up through your feet and up through your legs. Okay, and as that energy is coming up through your legs, there is a sense of expansion. So it's like it's coming up and out and open like this. Oh, there! the light has changed when I do that. Yeah, so how does this feel when you have a sense of the energy coming up and out and filling into your energy field? What's that feel like? And allow, again, have that sense of receiving. So as you're opening up and out like this, receive. So receive the energy that's coming up, receive the energy that's filling into your energy field. Oh, Rosalie, lots of yawning. Yeah, that feels like a letting go. Almost like you've been carrying things that maybe you don't need to carry anymore. And the yawning is just a letting go. Feels good. Yeah. Regina, hey. Feeling something in your throat. Okay, so do you want to imagine that you're receiving through your throat? Because it's almost like there's a constriction around, I can't receive kind of verbally. See what that feels like. And notice the energy, and this feels relevant for everybody. If you notice the energy through your throat, through your solar plexus, and down to your low body, the lower part of your body, there's a realigning happening. So it's as if there's an opening up coming through the whole central channel, and almost like daring to expand. So you know the way we've all had to really kind of shrink our worlds in a lot of ways and just kind of close in and come into a smaller space in many ways. This, what we're doing here right now, looks like we're kind of opening up to or owning a bigger space, and maybe in a different way. But the sense of, oh, actually, hold on, there is a bigger space for me. So notice and see how does that feel. To me, I'm getting chills all over. See how that feels. Hey, Isabella. How are you doing? Good to have you here. So that owning your bigger space, how does that feel? At at our lower back here and all the way up through our back. It's almost like things that have been sort of sitting behind us, so old energies that have been sitting behind us, like grief and loss and fear and anxiety and, you know, all the things that have probably been coming up over the last year, perhaps. And what it looks like, there's almost like this, kind of like an angelic energy that's coming whooshing in, and it's kind of just lifting up all of these energies that are behind us. If you want to imagine or have a sense of this kind of whooshing energy coming up, and it's just lifting the whole space, and it just is feeling so much lighter at our backs. Regina, it feels free and out. Brilliant. Yeah, brilliant. Oh, yeah, it's like this energy that can flow, and if you imagine it flowing out and see how that feels. And as well, you're detoxing, energetically upgrading, as your friend calls it. Yeah. It feels like part of that upgrading is kind of, you know, what we've been talking about here about opening up for receiving and opening up into bigger space. That feels really relevant for your upgrading. So you can see how that feels, and that detoxing and letting go. It's like decluttering. You like decluttering, isn't it? We have more space when we let go of the old. So it feels nice. I know it can be uncomfortable sometimes, but it feels nice. Daphne, it feels empowering and expansive. Nice. Yeah, and that looks like you're owning, like you're owning your space and you're owning your energy and you're owning like your yes. So whatever it is you're wanting or feeling called to say yes to. So yeah, and as well, thank you. Ah, okay. Hopefully that resonates. Yeah. So if you want to feel into your wider energy field now, I need a wider camera here, but if you feel into your wider energy field, so you're kind of feeling the edges of whatever your field is as it's showing up at the moment. So you're putting attention sort of, yeah, further out, like it's going to be different for everybody, but just however far out into your field feels right. And notice how you feel. To me, it feels like there's a relaxing and a letting go. And with that relaxing and letting go, again, there's that sense of releasing different themes, almost, like different themes that we've been experiencing through the year. And even if you want to imagine, what are some of the themes that have been going on for you this year? Like, has there been a lot of growth in a particular area? Or has there been kind of a repeated experience of any kind? So just notice any kind of themes that catch your attention or come into your awareness. Okay, and as you're doing that, it feels like a relief. It's like, oh, thank goodness, maybe I can just almost like move on from that repeated theme. So I don't know if this is making sense to anybody. Hopefully there's a resonance for you. Because it feels like there's a completion coming in around whatever the themes are that are catching your attention. So Isabel, you're not detoxing on purpose, your body just went to it and felt it coming. Yeah, it feels right, it feels like it's the right timing for it. So, yeah. Hey Ruth. Oh, just on your phone, it's not the clearest connection. No worries, hopefully you'll get whatever it is that's relevant for you. And welcome. And Isabella, makes sense, brilliant. Yeah. Okay, there is something coming in now around how would you love to be experiencing next year and moving into next year? Like, what are the themes that you are feeling you would love for next year? So it looks like, you know, we've been doing some releasing in our energy, a completion of the old, and we've kind of opened up our space, opened up our energy field. And now there's a sense of what would I love to be experiencing? So yeah, with that more open energy, with that more open feeling, then it becomes easier to have a sense of, oh, well, you know, I'd love this or that. So, yeah, so what would you love to experience more? It could be feelings, it could be practical experiences, it could be, I don't know, different ways of thinking, it could be different kind of connections, all sorts of different things. So just feel into what you would love for next year. And feel Sandra, thanks Ruth, I thought I'd get into the spirit. I was really warm, I'm melting here. And just for whatever it is you would love to experience more of. Oh, Rosaline, freedom. Yeah, nice. So have a sense of how do you feel about that? So like, for example, how do you feel about freedom or having more freedom? And notice, do you feel open to it? Do you feel sort of like, yes, it'd be nice, but I still feel closed? Or, you know, are you going, yes? Or are you going, or are you having a big yes? If that makes sense. So just notice how you feel about the thing that is that you'd love to experience. Okay, and there's an energy coming in now. And actually some of the essences are coming in now. Some of the alignment essences. Hold on a second, let's see. So the restoring function essence from the alignment set, the reconnection with source, and realigning with soul's blueprint are all coming in. So if you want to allow them to just come in, we'll just allow them to come in energetically rather than reading the affirmations. Let's read the affirmation. So the restoring function essence, I allow this essence to support me to restore my ability to function in the way that I am naturally able to. Allow it to support me to realign with my authentic human and soul level abilities, skills, knowledge, and gifts. Okay, so as you're allowing this energy to come in, you might have a sense of almost kind of remembering things that you may know at a soul level, perhaps. It's like things that you know already and may not have been living or bringing in. This is supporting to bring them in, which feels really, really, really good moving forwards. And then the reconnection with source essence, if you want to allow this to come in. So I allow this essence to support me to connect with source, God, and the universe, to be in my own channel and my own unique expression and experience. I allow it to support me to let go and to trust in the goodness of life. Oh, so notice how you feel with this. This looks like, an aligning with your own source connection, your own expression, you know, as the universe, your own sense of, you know, you're here for a reason and a purpose, and you can choose, that you can make choices that feel uplifting and expansive. Yeah, so notice what's going on in your energy with this. And then the realigning with soul's blueprint essence. I allow this essence to support me to align with the divic blueprint of my soul, with my true expression, my true essence. I allow it to support me to align with the wisdom, love, and joy of my soul, and to be my true self. So if you allow this to come in, again, it's bringing in that sense of alignment with yourself, you know, as we move forward, and as we're having the sense of whatever qualities, whatever themes we'd love to experience more of. So as these essences are coming, just notice, is there something shifting in your energy around that? So the freedom, is there something more open around that? New love partner, just notice how you're feeling about this. The joy, just notice how you're feeling around that. You know, is there something shifting? Are you feeling more like you're coming more into alignment with them? To me, it feels like there's quite a definite energy of this is almost like, yeah, this is what I'm choosing, or this is what I'm, yeah, this is what I'm aligning with. So how's this feeling for anyone? Can you feel the shifts happening? I can feel there's lots going on through our energy, especially around our back and, well, all over. And there's quite a lot around giving yourself permission, like it's okay. It's almost like letting go of any programs or patterns of I'm supposed to be suffering, or I'm supposed to be struggling, or I'm supposed to be doing things the hard way. It's like we're letting go of some of those and allowing, and you know what, maybe this can work more easily, maybe this can come in an easier way. And there's that sense of permission, like that's okay. It's okay for things to come in an easier way or a lighter way. So Regina, feeling excited. Nice. Yeah, nice. And so any of those kind of good feelings you're feeling, have the intention that you are allowing yourself to embody those feelings more. So if you're feeling excited, just go, okay, I allow myself to really embody that feeling of excitement, or anything else you're feeling. Ruth, like a rebalancing happening. Yeah. It's like a rebalancing and more stability coming in. So then we're moving forward with a stronger foundation, or a richer foundation. It's one of those things I'll share more about at some stages, that I have a an oak tree analogy. So I may have mentioned it before, I'm not sure. If you know, every acorn has all the information in it that it needs to become a magnificent oak tree. And then it's in the environment that determines how that it actually ends up expressing. So, you know, when it has really good soil, it's just right for it. When it is, you know, has the light and the whole atmosphere that's right for it, it's going to flourish. You know, the tree, other trees aren't too close and not too far, you know, all that sort of thing. The right microbes, all and so on. And so it feels like part of what we're doing here is really helping, you know, we're like an oak tree, basically. We have the information within us to completely flourish as who we are, but we need the right environment to optimize that. And so what we're doing here is our soil. It's like our soil equivalent, you know, the equivalent of whatever the soil is for us. It feels like it's just, yeah, it's enriching, or it's becoming more vibrant or more, I kind of want to say earthy as well. So I don't know if you have a sense of that. And then of course, when our soil is right, really right for us, or optimal for us, then we can flourish. So how's this feeling for anybody at the moment? Does anybody want to mention anything? It feels like this piece that wants to come in. It can be that sometimes we just need to decide on a fresh start. We might need to go, do you know what? Okay, I'm just allowing myself to have a fresh start. That feels relevant for some people. And there's also another piece around that it can be a smooth transition. It's like the transition from where we have been to where we're going can be smooth. So that feels relevant for some people. And there's something else around. We can make big shifts if we choose to. It's like we don't need to make incremental shifts. Sometimes that's perfect, but other times we can make a big shift and that's what's aligned, that's what's in flow, that is what feels most natural. So it's okay to allow yourself to just go, I'm just taking this big step, or I'm just doing that, making this big shift because it feels most natural. So that feels relevant for some people as well. So see if any of those resonate. So Rudina, knowing you deserve all the goodness coming in. Yes. Yeah. And yeah, so if you want to really embody that, it's like going, okay, I really let myself feel that sense of deserving. So it becomes much more a part of you and becomes really, yeah, embodied. And definitely a feeling of freedom and excitement. Yay. Nice. And Isabella resonates, brilliant. Yeah, nice. And definitely a smooth transition. It's very relevant. Nice. Yeah. So it's that sense of it's okay. So Ruth feels like a birth. Oh yes, nice. Yeah, it does, like that freshness. And kind of like the joy that's associated with birth as well. So and Isabella, I wondered about that this year, that you've seen many people make quick big shifts. Yeah, it feels like it's almost like everything has kind of been fallen away in some ways. And so it can be easier because everything's just different. It can be easier to make big shifts. And also there's that sense of the time is now. It's like, so whereas before we might have been just going dum-de-dum-dum, you know, and gradually making the bits, now it's like, okay, well, now is the time. And there are kind of multiple windows open for these opportunities that we can take. So, okay, how's everybody doing? Does it feel like it's completing? It feels like there's another piece that needs to land in. So if you feel into next year and what it is that you're choosing moving forwards, and feel into that sense of being aligned with it, that you're allowing it, that you're open, that you're receiving. Okay, so now imagine you're taking a step forward. You can physically take a step forward if you want, or just imagine you're taking a step forwards. And notice how you're feeling then when you're in that new space, you know, after you've taken that step. Again, there's like a sense of landing, grounding, integrating. There's a sense of freedom within that. It's almost like a lot of old cords and connections and what are they? Like old operating systems. They look like they've kind of fallen away with what we've been doing here. And then in this new space, it's just, yeah, it's fresher, it's more free. Now, sometimes, you know, our habitual way of being can, even though we've moved forward, our habitual way can kind of pop up again. So if you notice something that you recognize and go, oh, hold on, that's the old energy, then just notice that and go, okay, that I acknowledge that, I appreciate that, and I release that. And so then again, you give yourself permission to be in a new energy. Okay, and there's also something coming in around, again, this relates to our environment, around the people around us, because of course we're all moving at different paces, we're all going in different directions, we all have different priorities maybe, or things that are, you know, that we're really resonating with. So there's something coming in around harmony and allowing harmony within ourselves and the people around us so that we can all move forward in harmony. And it's something with my eyes. Oh yes. Yeah, you're right. Something about seeing. It's like that space of more possibilities, and it's okay to be in that space of more possibilities. Yeah. I'll explore it a little bit more. So, and Rosaline feels so light. Yeah. Oh, so do you want, so there is an energy coming in around this that can come into water if you want to. It's more like an elixir. It's more like an elixir. So if you want to either now or later on get a glass or a bottle of water and have the intention that that water is for this elixir, which is around this shift that we're talking about here. So it's a frequency that can ground into the water. All you need to do is have the intention, and it's kind of all set up energetically for it to come in. And then when you drink that water, it just helps you to really ground and balance and stabilize and harmonize with this new energy. It feels really nice, very freeing. It's a similar elixir, but we'll all have a different, you know, it'll be just slightly different for all of us because we're all different. And then when you allow it to ground into the water or be held into the water, of course you're co-creating that, so whatever's going on for you will help contribute to what's going on there so that it's right for you or that matches you, if that makes sense. So you can do that either now or later on if you would like to. What's it, we could call it the elixir of transitioning from 2021 to 2022 or something along those lines. Yeah. A different flavour, yeah. Everyone has their own unique flavour. Okay, well, that feels good. Okay, I feel like that's completing. Does that feel complete for everyone? Yeah. Okay, so it's just like everything's just landing. So, so thank you. It's really cool. And thank you for sharing and for your comments as well. It's really, I love that, so. And I wish you an amazing holidays, and we'll see you in the new year, and enjoy the, like, that transition into that new energy, and yeah, we'll see you soon, and thank you so much again. Okay, take care, sending lots of love, bye.